Shah, Yah Wabah Chim Yah Shah, Baha Chim Rahat Adash. The Lord Tim Positives and Prophets, who I teach more sincerity and truth, which they last are free to do so. And to the hopeful link, to the confusion of faith, we join them to our race and now scattered across the full point of the globe. And to the Akim Akwata, this I learned to you, I said, Shalom. And today's lesson, they, you know, come straight from the hip, is entitled The Straight Gate, or, you know, The Straight Gate, you know, something to that effect. Because, you know, that, it's, you know, because in the scriptures, you know, according to, you know, for your house, y'all said, that it's going to be two gates.
Jake,
song 147, 19, and 20. You know, he only showed the gay law, statute, commandments to Israel anyway. Even though that he only gave the law, statutes, and commandments only to the Israelites, but yeah, you got a lot of people are going down that broad gate. Because a lot of our people are going to be destroyed according to Zechariah 13 and 8. You know, two-thirds of our people, because two-thirds of our people are wicked. You know, they don't want to repent. You know, they don't want to come back to the law, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shah. You know, they want to stay keeping these holidays. You know, they want to stay keeping Christmas, New Year's, Thanksgiving, Valentine's Day, a lot of these pagan holidays, Halloween. And they quit saying, oh, we do a Christian Halloween church, which there's no such thing. Because Halloween is basically, it's a holiday for the wicked. Well, all the holidays are for the wicked. Yeah, you got Christians that they're trying to justify the reason why they celebrate these holidays, and they can't pull one scripture out to show it, to show anybody that Most High says okay to celebrate Christmas and Thanksgiving and New Year's and all these pagan holidays, 4th of July. You know, you can, the list keep going on and on. That's why a lot of, you know, a lot of our people is going to go down that broad gate. Because in their mind, they believe what they're doing is right. You know, they believe that Yahweh's dealing with them on the level. And they could do whatever they want to do. They could go out and they could live a life. They could live any type of life. They could live in wickedness. They can, you know, they can eat poor shrimp and lobster. They can break all the commandments in the Bible, and it won't be no consequence or repercussions. All they gotta do is say a quick prayer to, you know, Jesus, which, you know, Lil J won the Vengeance to 1634, by the way. And they can do all types of madness. And they still somehow believe that the Most High is still dealing with them. You know, they believe the Most High is dealing with them, and the Most High is blessing them, and all this other madness. You know, especially among our women. Our men, women are the biggest contributors of Christianity. Because when you try to tell them that they supposed to follow order, you know, they bunk up. You know, you got women that are pastors. And they lead our people down that broad gate, you know, that gate to destruction. Because women supposed to learn in silence. You know, the scripture says if they have a question, they supposed to ask their husband at home. And you know, you're going to have some women that are going to try to dance around scripture. Well, I ain't got no husband. Well, you got a father. You know, you got the men of the Lord. You can ask a question. But, you know, you don't go and come in. Going to church disrupts the true man of the Lord. You know, if you got a question, you're supposed to ask your husband at home. You ask the man of the Lord, you're supposed to keep silent. But a lot of women out there are going to call, you know, call down people to go into that broad gate. Because a lot of women love to run their mouth. And they love the art, and they trying to justify. They part of that two-third club. But you only going to have a few aquas out there. A few aquas that are listening and learning. And they're striving to get into the straight gate. But a lot of our women, they hit into that broad gate. Especially a lot of feminine men out there, too. You know, they going to get into that broad gate. Because they going to get into the gate that's going to lead to destruction. Because they refuse to repent and they followed after that woman. You know, Yahweh commands the man, he's supposed to lead the house. He's supposed to be the head of the household. Because scripture said that the leader, the head of the woman is the man. And the head of the man is Yahawashah. And head of Yahawashah is Yahawah. You know, Most High has an order. And a lot of people go going in that wrong gate and lead to destruction because they refuse to follow order. And a lot of people gonna go into that wrong gate. I'm not worried about the heathen because it wasn't the heathen ain't giving the law, statute, commandments anyway, especially Esau, they're not giving no laws anyway because they're rejected according to Hebrews chapter 12, 16 to 17. A lot of people, like I said, they're going to head into that broad gate because of the wickedness and because they disobedience to Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. They talk about the broad gate, quite a bit because a lot of our people are going to enter into that. Yahshua made a plan. Many shall be there going there, and many our people is going to go into that broad gate. Because a lot of our people, like I said, they refuse to keep the law, statute, and commandments of the Most High, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah. They refuse to celebrate the High Holy Days, which Yahweh commanded us to throughout the scriptures. That we should, we in the Passover. We're supposed to be celebrating the Passover. But you got a lot of our people, they refuse. Want to celebrate the Passover, they look at that as something that's not cool. That's not something of the world. And our people are going to go into that broad gate. A lot of people, they carnal minded. They love the things of this world. First John said that, love of the Yahweh not in them. They had no love for Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shah. Our people are prideful. They know they high-minded, they arrogant. You can't tell them anything when it comes down to the scripture. They claim that they love Yahweh, but when you start putting out scripture telling them about their wickedness and telling them they have to repent and come out of Babylon, which according to that's a Revelation chapter 18, verse 4, come out of Babylon but got a lot of our people, they don't want to come out of Babylon. They'll stay trusting them in oppression. They stay trusting in wickedness. And they think that Yahweh is dealing with them, until our people repent and come back to your head to Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shah and turn away from wickedness and forsake Babylon and come back to the law, statutes, and commandments. So Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shah, the Most High ain't dealing with them. Period. Be slaughtered for being the two-third club. And a lot of our people are born into that broad gate. They refuse to wake up and they refuse to repent. And, it said that it will lead to destruction. And many should be there going there. But there's another gate that Yahawashah talked about. He talked about the straight gate, which leadeth unto life, and few that be that find it. Right, it's only the few people that's going to find it, and there's few people, for those who don't know, it's going to be the whole four left, the 144,000 and the one-third. That's the few people that's going to find that straight gate. And what is that straight gate? That straight gate, it's the truth. There's no need to life, that the hopeful elect and the one third is, it was chosen to go to that straight gate that's going to lead to life and free that be that fighter. Most I already got the select people that he's going to allow to enter into the straight gate. That's going to lead to life, like it. And, it's going gonna be that 144,000 in the one-third. They're gonna go into the straight gate. And that straight gate is the truth. They're gonna be keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. They're gonna be walking upright before Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shah. they're going to be doing him well. They're going to, they'll be keeping all the feast days. They're going to keep the law, statute, and commandments to the best of their ability, you know, through faith. They're going to do everything that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah commanded them to do. And this train gate is leading to life. And few that we going to find it. Why? Because there's a few people that's going to really serve Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah with everything that they got. You know, they're going to be serving Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah with all their soul, heart, mind, and strength. They're going to give everything that they got to serve Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. You know, they're going to be striving to get into the straight gate. Every day they're striving to get into the straight gate. Every day they got the brothers on the highways and byways. Teach a lesson. You got brothers come on YouTube bringing out lessons to edify, to wake up the hope for that, and also to edify Israel. You know, tell Israel, you know, tell the people of Israel, you know, following the Ruach HaKodesh to repent, to get right, to go, this is the way, you know, according to 1 John, I believe, chapter 2 and 6, you know, this is the way, walk ye in it. You know, come on, you know, this, if you want to get into a straight gate, you know, this is the way, this is what, according to scripture, this is what you need to do. Our people, you know, the ones in the straight gate, you know, they sign the crime. They prophesying against this place, they prophesying against sin, they going against wickedness. You know, they don't want to have nothing to do with wickedness. You know, every day they strive to get into the straight gate. You know, they really have some freedom to, you know, to enter into the straight gate. They don't have no, they don't care nothing about this world. They don't care about, you know, want to be popular or anything. They want to serve Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah to the best of their ability. You know, that's the reason why. The whole for lit, the 144,000 1/3, they're going to go into their straight gate because they're slotted, you know, by Yahweh and it's on Yahweh Shah too. They were chosen to enter into the straight gate, which lead into life. And you're going to see it in that day. You know, you're going to see that the 144,000 1/3, they're going to enter into the straight gate. And also when time for Babylon the Great to go down, you're gonna see the hopeful lead, the 144,000 and the 1/3, they're gonna get beamed up into the chariots. The Most High is gonna get them out of destruction. You know, they're gonna be slaughtered, they're gonna be chosen to be whisked away out of this destruction, the nuclear destruction. They're gonna see eternal life. They will see the crowns in the kingdom of heaven because the hopeful that in the 1/3 they did what they supposed to do. You know, they were chosen and they followed Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah to the best of their ability. And you know, they kept his law, statutes, and commandments. You know. According to scripture, where Yahweh Shah told the rich man that asked what good thing he supposed to do to inherit eternal life. According to Matthew 19:17, Yahweh Shah said to the Pharisee, you know, if you want to enter life, you know, you keep the commandments. And that was the hopeful land of 1/3 has been doing. They keeping the law, statute, and commandments. You know, they keeping it to the best of their ability. When they fall short, they repent. And they gonna enter to the straight gate. And that's what's going on. They gonna enter to the straight gate. They're going to receive eternal life from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. You know, that's it for the lesson. I want to talk about the broad gate and want to talk about the straight gate, because a lot of our people, they're going to enter into the broad gate, you know, know, that two-thirds club, they going to head into the broad gate because, like I said, they going to, they're not going to keep no law, statute, commandment. They going to live their life. They going to do what they want to do. And they going to be destroyed on this side. And the ones that in the straight gate, the hopeful there, the one-third, they going to receive eternal life. And they going to be with Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah. And, you know, 144,000 is going to be the reigning, going to be reigning with Yahweh Shah. According to the scriptures. You know, that's it for a lesson. All praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rahamadash, the honors to the apostles, elders, and the prophets, who I teach the word of sincerity and truth, and to the hopeful let, and to the confusion of faces, and the Akim and Akwath that are this and learning. Until next time, Yahweh willing, Shalom.